Yes, good morning. Buenos días a todos ustedes. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Again, thank you, Congressman Cuellar, for not letting this issue get further out of hand. We also have my counterpart in Nuevo Laredo, the Presidente Municipal Enrique Rivas Cuellar. I'm happy to report that as of April the 15th, CBP agents that were deployed from the World Trade Bridge, some have come. And now a Columbia Bridge is fully manned. World Trade Bridge is, we're getting there, but operations are a lot better. As to these two bridges, CBP has said that they will continue to operate with all lanes open in order to catch up with all the backlog from these past 2 weeks that we became short-staffed. Like I said, it's great news. More improvement is required, but we still have shortage of agents at our other ports of entry, and we're working with CBP to bring those people back as soon as possible. We need every single CBP agent back, and we will continue to do our part to impress this on CBP and our federal officials as well, because we know that our port is growing. We've been told that by next year we'll probably be having 10,000 trucks traversing our, you know, commercial trucks traversing those two commercial bridges, and that's very significant. And of course, we'll need every CBP officer back plus more, and that's where we need to make that known to our Washington officials, which we are, and we'll continue to impress that message throughout. And again, this is not an issue of inconvenience. It's truly life and death for many businesses here at the border and those who are employed in the trade sector. And of course, it's a ripple effect. This impacts every aspect of trade life throughout the U.S. and other countries as well. Again, I reiterate, we continue to ask the administration to return all of our CBP officers to the ports and to utilize other agencies to help with migrant operations on the southern border. Thank you. I would call upon my counterpart, Enrique Rivas Cuellar, to address you. Excuse me. Thank you.
Gracias. Muy buenos días. Acabamos de terminar una reunión de trabajo donde, sin duda alguna, los puntos que abordamos fue la recuperación de los oficiales, el regreso de oficiales para poder aligerar, para poder los tiempos de espera acortarlos, para que se vea lo menos afectado este importante cruce del comercio exterior para los Estados Unidos y para Nuevo Laredo. Yo quiero agradecer el liderazgo del congresista Henry Cuellar, que sin duda alguna ha permitido ir regresando poco a poco a los oficiales de CBP, y donde el trabajo en equipo, aquí lo que estamos haciendo es colaborando, intercambiando información, cada quien asumiendo la tarea para poder buscar las soluciones necesarias y coordinarnos como lo hemos venido haciendo el mayor Pete Sainz, al cual también le agradezco la hospitalidad de recibirnos aquí y llevar a cabo este tipo de trabajos, donde participan dependencias federales, estatales, de la ciudad de Laredo, Texas, pero donde también están participando las dependencias, las agencias o las dependencias estatales, federales y municipales de Nuevo Laredo. Hace unos momentos nos acompañaron también, entre otras autoridades, las dos cónsul, la cónsul Carolina Zaragoza, cónsul de México en Laredo, Texas, y la cónsul Catherine Flashback, que es cónsul de Estados Unidos en Nuevo Laredo. Y de esta manera están todos sentados en la mesa para buscar las soluciones. Y nuevamente el reconocimiento por parte de la ciudad de Nuevo Laredo al congresista Henry Cuellar, porque gracias a Henry Cuellar ha sido posible poder ir recuperando poco a poco a los oficiales y obviamente aligerar los tiempos de espera para el cruce de la aduana más importante de no solamente de México, sino de América Latina. Muchísimas gracias y muy buenos días. Gracias, congresista.
Thank you.
Muchas gracias.
Congressman.
Okay, thank you. I also want to thank Mayor Pete Sainz for the leadership
that he has provided on behalf of the city during this very difficult time where they took 300 CBP officers from the Laredo sector, that means from Del Rio all the way down to Brownsville, took them down there to go work at the Border Patrol station in McAllen. They also took people from El Paso. That was the second largest amount. And then from there, they also took people from Arizona and New Mexico. But the largest amount, the 500 out of 545, 300 came from our sector, so we got hit the hardest. So I want to thank the mayor for the leadership and working all together as a team. And also el alcalde de Nuevo Laredo, también trabajando como un equipo. Porque nosotros sabemos, como dijo el alcalde, estamos trabajando con un equipo. Y lo quiero dar muchas gracias por el trabajo que usted hizo durante el tiempo que era difícil para nuestro puerto. As you know, we had originally the former Secretary of Homeland wanted to take 750 individuals from CBP. They took only 545. The problem is they took 300 from the port of Laredo, or should I say the district of Laredo, which is again our largest area came in. So they took 300 from this area. They took 194 people from El Paso, which is the second largest area. And then the rest, smaller amounts from Arizona and New Mexico. So when we were able to provide the secretary, and at that time he was a CBP commissioner, and as you know, Kevin Michelini, who was Señor Internacional a couple years ago, the secretary now, the acting secretary, we provided him some ideas on what to do. They jumped on the first one where they started returning some of the folks back. Out of the first, this last weekend, they got 100 people back. 60 of those 100 came to Laredo, Port of Laredo, that is the World Trade Bridge and Columbia. So by Tuesday, a couple days ago, we are back to normal. I would say almost back to normal. We have the private sector. We'll let them say, give us their opinion. This weekend, they will return another 125 members of CBP this weekend. So that means by Monday and Tuesday, another 125 out of the 545 will be back. Where they would put them, I would assume, because we also had Congressman Filemon Vela that represents the Brownsville area, and Congressman Vicente Gonzalez, they were available by phone also. We think that some of those people will go to cover Brownsville and the other areas in the valley, and maybe we'll get a little bit more back over here, and then some in the other areas, Arizona, New Mexico, on that. So by the end of this weekend, there will be 225 out of the 545 people who will come back at that time. We're hoping that they will return more people in the future. Now, without going into details, my staff should hand out what I call my talking points, and then there I go into very detailed transportation. The contract for moving people around will be expanded. New buses will use for transportation. And then, of course, the other issue that we want them to look at is the overtime. Now, the secretary on April 12 did sign a waiver. The problem is they haven't asked Congress for reprogramming of any monies they might need. And again, with all due respect to the Trump administration, they can move money around for the wall. I think they can move money over for an overtime rather easily. If they can move billions of dollars, they can certainly move millions of dollars to do waivers. The other thing we're going to look at is the possibility is the law that we changed some years ago to allow the private-public partnership. There is an agreement that's in place that goes from the valley all the way to Laredo that can allow us to do overtime. If the private sector wants to pay overtime like they've done, like they do at airports, that's another possibility. I know there's a low thing that they have to work on, and we're hoping that we can work this out with Homeland, but we want to provide
all the possibilities on overtime so they can get this done. Volunteers, there are volunteers that are coming down, and by Monday of April 22nd, there will be volunteers that will be go down there in the valley, and we're hoping that that will allow us to bring more people back. It also includes people from other ports of entry, whether it's from New York, Chicago, wherever the case might be, but everybody has to share the pain and not let the Laredo sector carry about 15% of our personnel that got taken over there. So there are some other ideas that we have, and we will talk to them. We also, this last appropriations, we added money for CBP, $58.7 million, to hire 600 new CBP officers. We were told that with this money, they should be able to hire the people by the end of the year. Now, it won't solve the problem we have right now, but long term, this new 600 CBP officers that have been funded, that we put the money in February, will be there. And then we also gave them the authority to use custom fees to add another 600. So it's really a total of 1,200 new CBP officers that should be able to come, at least 600 of them by the end of the year if they move quickly on this. So bottom line is we're seeing movement on this. I think World Trade Bridge in Columbia is almost back to normal, but I'd rather hear from our friends over here, the transportation can tell us that, and I'll ask them to come up here and say a few words. And also, the mayor, Mayor Pete Sines, I want to thank Robert Eats, and of course the mayor and your team, and of course CBP, GSA, everybody that's been working. We have, and we're not going to talk about this right now, we're going to wait till later, but we are moving on some items, some infrastructure changes for the World Trade Bridge that should move things a lot faster, and we'll talk about that next week, and we'll show you what we're working. The timetable, and thank you, Robert, has been moved and compressed, that I think you're going to start seeing things moving pretty quickly. But we'll talk about that. So we're not only looking at bringing the CBP officers back, but we're looking at some infrastructure, how trucks pass through the World Trade Bridge, how they exit, what sort of work that we're doing so we can move that a lot faster. And we're excited about that because a timetable that the city, that the Texas Department of Transportation, CBP, I think by putting all those together, you're going to see movement coming out of the World Trade Bridge on a faster pace than we're seeing. So I certainly want to thank him in advance. We'll talk about this in detail in the next week or 2 weeks and give you details as to what we're doing. But at this time, why don't we go ahead and hear from our folks in the transportation, both on the U.S. and Mexican side, so you can hear and they can give you their perspective on how traffic is hopefully getting back to normal at the World Trade Bridge and at the Columbia Bridge. So. Do y'all want to, both of y'all?
Thank you very much.
Good morning, everybody. Jerry Maldonado with the Laredo Motor Carriers Association. First of all, I'd like to thank Congressman Cuellar, the mayor, and the mayor of Nuevo Laredo also, and our CBP people. We work very closely with them throughout all the issues that come up as they come up. You know, the issue we had a couple of years ago with the weather, this issue that we currently have with the migrants, and the repositioning of staff from our Laredo port directly to the other areas. We are grateful to be involved. We are grateful that they keep us at the table. At the end of the day, you know, we work as a team, and this is something that we will continue to do forever, in our opinion. As he mentioned earlier, the wait times have have gotten better. Columbia is pretty much at 100% how it used to be in before the issue. World Trade Bridge, we probably have about an hour and a half more of delay, but it's something that is very manageable nowadays. Our wait times were doubled, almost, you know, went a little over double in the past couple of weeks when we had the issues at its worst. But, you know, we come down, we get together, we focus on the important part of the Laredo import and export, the industry, the World Trade Bridge in Columbia, and that's where we're at. We're able to work together and bring our officers back and give the priority to where we need the help the most. As he also mentioned, you know, their infrastructure news that are going to come out in a week or two. We're also grateful with our leadership, our politicians, that they involve us, they bring us to the table, and they get our input. And it is something that is going to benefit all of us at the end of the day in the industry, to be able to get our trucks in and out of Laredo, in and out of the bridges, a lot faster and a lot quicker. So, you know, again, thank you for all your leadership. Thank you for all the help, and thank you for always inviting us and bringing us to the table. Thank you very much.
Thank you. My name is Dionisio Gonzalez de Castilla, president of ALFA, Association of Freight Forwarding and Logistics of Laredo. Also with my Asociación de Agentes Aduanales de Nuevo Laredo, with our president, Edgardo Pedraza. We would like to thank all the federal, state, and local people that we have been working together, the private sector. And we would like to please give you thanks for take our opinion in consideration to try to make things faster. The facts has been said here. The only thing that I can say is this is a good example that when we work as a team, the federal, state, local, private sector, we can move Laredo, both Laredos. This is the second time last year with the storm, and now with the winds and these cows that has been going on right now, and we move faster and we solve it. We're not 100%, but we're working on that, and thank you very much.
Gracias. Gracias. Thank you.
I guess at this point we can open up for questions.
Yeah, the mayor signs, Mayor Rivas will take all the hard questions. If you want a yes or no from me, a thumbs up, I'll be happy to do that. I'm just kidding. Go ahead. Yeah. My understanding, they went cargo is the emphasis here. And we're hoping, you know, that was out of the 100 they got returned last Saturday and Sunday, started this last Monday and Tuesday. As I mentioned, 60 for cargo here, Laredo, World Troy Bridge, and the other one. But I think all the cities on the valley, and we were talking about the city of Far and other places down the valley, the returns on them are going to be in cargo. Because if we have $1.5 billion worth of trade, that's where we need to emphasize for right now as we bring additional officers over. We're concerned about the folks coming in, but we're certainly, we're concerned about the $1.5 billion of trade every day between the U.S. and Mexico.
So are we expecting some more tourism again about bridges?
I'm sorry?
Are we expecting more names and bridges over here?
Well, yeah, well, again, CBP has decided to bring back the people along the border on cargo emphasis. And if they move some people, that's up to their internal work. But their emphasis is to handle cargo. Bueno, los 300 no eran de Laredo nomás, eran del distrito de Laredo, que de Río al Valle. Los primer 100, Laredo recibió 60 aquí en Laredo, 40 se fueron a El Paso, y esta semana, el fin de semana, el domingo y sábado, van a recibir 125 más. De esos 125 más, CBP va a hacer la decisión dónde van a poner los otros, pero yo creo que van a tratar de ayudar a Brownsville, a Far y las otras, porque las otras ciudades también no recibieron agentes la primera semana.
¿Y el resto hay noticias cuándo?
Y estos, y por eso yo di 5, ahora hay 6 ideas, se están moviendo en 2, pero en mi opinión deben de buscar las otras 3, 4 otras ideas. No sabemos, eso es algo que lo estamos pidiendo a CBP, no saben, pero esperamos que va a ser algo pronto. Y la cosa muy simple, Para mí, si vas a quitar 300 de la área de Laredo, ¿dónde está LA? ¿Dónde está Nueva York? ¿Dónde está Chicago? ¿Dónde está New Orleans? ¿Dónde está Houston? ¿Dónde están las otras ciudades? Deben de sacar un porcentaje chico y así se baja a esto. Porque como digo, después de LA, Laredo es número dos en toda la nación. Sí.
Entonces, ¿cuál será el plan o cómo se está, qué se está proponiendo al gobierno?
Sí. Esperamos que el secretario nuevo, Kevin McEnany, que tiene mucha experiencia, vamos a trabajar con él, porque mi posición, no estoy hablando de otros demócratas, nomás yo, la solución es muy simple. Alguien entra, se van a quedar, lo van a dar una audiencia y de ahí, si el juez dice que se queda, se queda. Muchas veces el 10% dice el juez que se queda, 90% lo van a rechazar. Y en ese momento ICE regresa a esas personas. En mi opinión, así lo hicimos en Ellis Island. Así lo hicimos en los 90 con las personas que venían de Brasil. Entraban, no entraban a los Estados Unidos, se quedaban en una parte. No hay suficiente espacio, pero en el pasado hemos usado tents o otras maneras de hacer esto. Yo sé que muchos de mis demócratas no están de acuerdo, pero esos demócratas no viven en la frontera. No entienden lo que está pasando aquí con nosotros aquí en Laredo, en Las Puentes, pero mi solución, y es algo que voy a hablar con el secretario nuevo, ayer hablamos un poco, y en mi opinión, entra alguien, no le damos el catch and release, no le damos el permiso, se quedan hasta que haya una audiencia, necesitamos los jueces en la frontera. Y eso es algo que la administración de Obama, la administración de Trump no entienden, porque lo que están haciendo ahorita los jueces que estamos nosotros poniendo, se mandan a Nueva York, a Chicago, porque dicen, allá está la gente, es que pescan, la gente se va con una familia a una parte y mandan los jueces allá. En mi opinión, los jueces deben estar aquí en la frontera. Y siempre dicen, oh, pues ¿quién se quiere mover a la frontera? Pues hay muchos abogados de la frontera. Acabamos de poner dos abogadas de Laredo, Elizabeth Martínez y Melissa Joy Hinojosa, que son de aquí, pero no, que son ahora juezas. El problema es que esperamos que se van a regresar. Hay muchas partes donde podemos poner esas cortes. Se pueden poner en el oficial, el former federal courthouse. Se pueden poner aquí. Aquí donde están, pueden cruzar y se van directamente a un juez. Esa es mi posición. Y lo voy a decir muy francamente, hay muchos de mis partidos que no están de acuerdo con eso. Pues lo hicimos en Ellis Island, lo hicimos en los 90 con personas de Brasil, y eso es lo que debemos hacer. Lo que estamos viendo ahorita es que en 2006, 90% de las personas que estaban entrando, 206, eran mexicanos. Y 206, en unas horas, 95% de esos mexicanos que entraban se regresaban en horas. Ahora, la mayoría de personas que están entrando no son de México, son de Centroamérica y de otros países que están entrando. Y ahora, 97% de las personas se quedan aquí, que están entrando, se quedan. No, es que nomás el 3% se regresan. Es que lo que estamos viendo es totalmente del 2006 ahorita ha cambiado mucho. Yo entiendo lo que está pasando en Centro Médico, yo sé que es tan difícil, pero abajo de la ley, si un juez hace esa decisión y se da, te da el día, como dice, su corte, el día en corte, y el juez dice, se van a regresar, se deben de regresar. Esa es mi opinión y esperamos hablar con el nuevo secretario para hablar si podemos hacer algo así. El problema es que Trump dice una cosa y a veces afecta más cuando tiene unas intenciones que entiendo lo que quiere hacer, pero lo hace de una manera que lo pone difícil para trabajar con él, muy francamente.
Perdón. Quiero dar un comentario también. Nos explicó CBP que probablemente 165 of the officers that were actually removed initially out of the 300 may not be coming back as soon as possible. He perceives maybe 2-3 months for that number to come back. And this is in spite of the volunteers that are volunteering from other federal agencies. So I ask for patience as well, and of course we've been insisting for those 300 to come back to the Laredo field office, which is really from Del Rio to to Brownsville. But they are focusing again on trade, on these commercial bridges. So as far as bridge 1 and 2, we may have some issues there, but I'm told that certain hours of the day it seems very normal. But just pick your times as to when you do cross, if you can. But again, we're insisting for them to bring back the 300 plus more. And the congressman did mention that 600 new CBP officers will be employed, hopefully by the end of the year. And they'll be located at the hot spots. And obviously, the southwestern border here, Laredo in particular, is truly a hot spot. Thank you.
And longer term, and the appropriations, not only do we add more money, 600 plus another 600, but on this new appropriations, I asked for entry-level positions for Border Patrol and CBP. We don't need to have those officers do asylum. We can have certain entry positions under CBP and Border Patrol to do that work. And we've talked to David Higgerson, we talked to people, they agree. Same thing on Border Patrol. We have some entry level positions. Remember, Border Patrol is 2,200 people short. I mean, they got the money to hire 2,200. They just haven't done a very good job at hiring people at Border Patrol. And so the money's there to hire 2,200 people. That money's there. They just have had a shortage that they haven't filled out. So what we're doing is I put money there, which I feel very confident we're going to do it, to hire 1,200 entry-level people. They'll do everything CBP does or Border Patrol can except arrest somebody. That's the only thing. They can do everything else. So they can be doing the asylum here. They can be at the Border Patrol station changing diapers, making food, taking people to the hospital, the entry-level positions, people can be there, and the people that are trained to do cargo inspection or tourism will be back over here. The only thing is we can't do that to the end of the year. We can't do that because, the appropriations will be at the end of the year, and hopefully there will be a shutdown by the president. If we do it at the end of the year, they should get these people. Those 1,200 people to start off will be good because they do a good job, then they can be recruited to become full CBP officers or especially full Border Patrol agents. They have a new pool of people that they can look at, and we're hoping that, those 1,200 should be down here in the valley to handle the processing or even here at this time, but that's a little bit longer. We have a lot more things that we can do. The good thing about it, this secretary, I will say this, he is a good man. He was down here. We recognized him a couple years as a Señor Internacional. He and I sit down once a quarter. I sent him a note the other day. I said, as a CBP commissioner, we used to go to dinner once a quarter. Are you going to do that as a secretary? He said, yes, I might have to carry a couple more security. But we have that type of relationship that he understands the border, and he's going to find balance on how we provide security at the border. I feel very, you haven't heard me say that about any Homeland Secretary in a long time. I think Jay Johnson was probably the last one. I will say that I, you know, he might have to follow some things that Trump wants that he might not agree with, but he works for the president. But I think this man is a good man. He's got a good heart, married to somebody from El Salvador. She was down here with us. Habla español, he's a good one. He understands. He's more, he does more on trade and tourism, but he's now got to do a lot more things as secretary on that. So I have to say, I give him kudos.
Do you know what they are waiting for in order to bring the rest of the 300 officers back,
if
more hires?
Well, they since they're getting too many people at the Border Patrol processing center, they need bodies there. And again, you know, my thing is I gave them, and on my points that I'm gonna give you, I don't know if my staff gave it to you, but you will see there, I went down on all the suggestions. I don't think they move fast enough on overtime, to be honest with you. You know, they ought to look at bringing the retirees, especially if they think this might take a while, contracting services that they're working on. So once they put other bodies there, some other volunteers, then we can bring the folks over here. Until they do that, it's hard to give you a time to do that. I do know that they're bringing in some volunteers starting Monday. We're hoping that once those volunteers go there, that maybe that would bring more bodies back. So we got 100, we got another 125 this week, and after that, they said we don't know, because it depends on some of these changes on that. So I'm gonna talk to the secretary and say, hey, there's other options. Are you moving on the other options on that? Anybody else? Mayor? Y'all wanna close?
Yeah, just to answer your question too, from my end, yeah, if the migrants increase, chances are, you know, it's going to remain the same. But if we're able to handle or at least control the migrant flow into the U.S., then hopefully we'll get our CBP officers quicker and sooner to the ports of origin.
All right. Gracias. Thank you. Thank you very much. Gracias.